population. These patients suffer from chronic abdominal pain, and essentially these patients have a rewiring of their nervous system, so even though they shouldn't experience pain, they actually do. So we ask the question, how are the nerves in the gut activated to cause chronic pain? So we took an example from the skin, where you can get both pain and itch, and as the name implies, this is irritable bowel syndrome. So we wondered if there was an irritation of the nerves in the gut. And essentially what we've found is that the receptors which mediate itch in the skin also mediate pain in the gut. So essentially these patients are suffering from a gut itch. We've done this in preclinical models, we've translated this through to human tissue, and now we hope to fundamentally take this through to a human treatment whereby a patient may be able to take a medication, a once daily pill, to treat their IBS and to treat their pain. Most people are familiar with what happens to their skin. You can get itch, for instance, you can get pain from your skin. So that led us to think, well, is there similar pathways in the gut which results in activation and sensitization of these nerves? And essentially that's what we've found, is that the same mechanisms and receptors which cause itch from our skin also activate and irritate our gut to sensitize these nerves and cause gut pain. And we know that they couple down to a receptor which is activated by wasabi. So most people may be familiar with wasabi, with a sushi. That's the ingredient which will blow the back of your head off, basically. That's the really strong, pungent mechanism there. So we know that these itch receptors couple to that. So essentially that's how you get the pain. It's because it activates a particular receptor on nerves. It activates them and basically sends a pain signal. And that's what's happening within your gut. These poor patients, they're feeling pain all the time. So understanding how that happens and why it's happening, and then how we can treat that is a crucial aspect. And that's why our research showing that some of these itch mechanisms are actually contributing to this chronic gut pain is really important.
Simon is doubly unlucky. The fur of his beloved cat triggers allergies that keep him awake all night with itchy skin. And he has irritable bowel syndrome, or IBS, which causes chronic gut pain and lacks treatments. Poor Simon. One night, while lying awake, scratching profusely, Simon thought, "Something is also irritating my gut. It's like my gut feels itchy." But that can't be right, Simon thought. Or could it? Curiously, he did some searching and found a brand new scientific paper which asked the same question. Researchers from Flinders University set out to identify the crucial ways in which gut nerves signal pain and how they contribute to chronic gut pain in many people like Simon. They found that the same receptors that signal itchy feelings on the skin also exist in the gut. Activation of these receptors activates gut neurons and makes them more sensitive. So, over time, activating these itch receptors results in pain being signaled more easily. In people with IBS, it looks like these itch receptors might be more present than in healthy people. This means that more neurons are activated, causing the feeling of more pain. This is big news. These gut itch receptors could be a new way to target the underlying cause of gut pain, rather than using opioids, which don't fix the problem. Simon's intuitions were great. Chronic gut pain is essentially a gut itch.